Alright, 888, factor polynomials. This is just a review, nothing new, but we're going to go through it anyway. Oops. Okay, to factor, you just have to ask yourself every single time what you have. We have 5, 9, and 4. Nothing will come out. It's a trinomial. It's a leading coefficient of not 1. So the 5 has to go over here. S squared plus 9 S plus 20 parentheses S and S plus and plus multiply to get 20, add to get 9 is 5 and 4, but we have to put the 5 back in. S plus 1 5 S plus 4. Binomial with a minus sign. So can you square root the n's? Yes. So it's a difference of squares. One's going to be a minus, one's going to be a plus. We square root 25d squared and get 5d. Square root 9 and get 3. Trinomial, nothing will come out. Coefficient is 1. Y and Y, minus and minus, 1 and 1, since they're the same, you can put that. Four times, can anything come out? No. So we put a line underneath each one. Take a 5x out. And you're left with y plus 1. Take a 6 out, you're left with y plus 1. So y plus 1, 5x plus 6. That's a 6. Okay, we have a trinomial. And because I know my multiplication tables, I know 7 goes into all of them. So we have to take a 7 out first. That's a Q, not a D. Leading coefficient is 3. So we have to take it over. Bring along a 7. Take down the 7. Multiply to get 9, subtract to get 8. Put the 3 back in. Okay. Now, on this one, it's a trinomial, nothing goes into all 3 of those, so I can't take anything out. But if you start with this number and you multiply it over here, I don't even want to think about what that answer is, okay? So maybe there's another way of doing it. And it is a special case. It's a perfect square because we can square root the, just 8b, and we can square root 5. If we multiply 8 and 5, we get 40. If we multiply that, we get 80. So it's a perfect square. 8b plus 5, because we put that sign in between it. That's it.